It's a very important issue, Minister, and it's, albeit, I suppose there's always going to have to be something that's at the tail end of a session, and it says more about the people who fail to look in on what we're doing than us actually in here carrying out the debate. It's frightening to think, you know, that one in five women will be abused by an intimate partner in their life, and I didn't realise the statistics were so high until I looked into it. And I suppose we're here talking about this issue today because of the concern as expressed in the Garda Inspectorate report, which detailed particular problems with attitudes towards domestic violence within the force, and finding that some complaints were treated as a waste of time. The report found that some members of the force displayed negative attitudes towards domestic violence by referring to calls as problematic, time-consuming and a waste of resources. In fact, the Chief Inspector, Robert Olson, of the Garda Síochána said, the whole issue of domestic violence needs to be thoroughly reviewed. We had about 11,000 domestic violence incidences and there were only 287 cases where somebody got arrested. Now that is an issue of huge concern, Minister, and that needs to be looked at and looked at fast. And I suppose part of the reason why maybe there's such few arrests is because there's not sufficient training for the members of An Garda Síochána. And I do acknowledge, as Deputy O'Keefe did, that there are very good members of the force doing excellent jobs. But Minister, it is worrying that the Garda Domestic Violence Training Programme has been axed for new Garda recruits due to a lack of funding from the Department of Justice and Equality. The programme, which had been run in the Garda College in Templemore, where Gardaí are educated, had been run by people who deal with rape victims on an ongoing basis, but due to the lack of funding, the forthcoming programme was ended. Now, Minister, I think that's something you need to commit to reintroduce if we're serious about tackling domestic abuse. And you, I think, indicated your willingness to look at signing the Istanbul Convention. And it's worth noting that Istanbul, it establishes a framework for governments to ensure robust action to prevent, investigate and prosecute and ultimately eliminate violence against women and girls. But unfortunately, you will never eliminate violence in total. As long as, excuse me for the unparliamentary language, but as long as we've evil bastards in the world, there will be domestic abuse. And what we need to do is ensure that we have sufficient resources put in place to deal with it. And we need to ensure that we have ring-fence budgets. And Minister, I decided to speak on this evening because a service in Longford that is providing supports in this area, and since 2005 they have supported 1,500 women who were subject to domestic abuse. In 2013, 248 women, and up to October of this year, 242 women, which is an absolute scandal for a county the size of Longford. But Minister, in the last number of years, my government and this government, they have seen unbelievable cuts. 17% reduction in HSC TUSLA funding for domestic violence services, 26% reduction in funding in the Commission for Support of Victims of Crime funding for domestic court accompaniment, and 47% reduction in Family Support Agency funding for counselling services. That is just not good enough, Minister. And if we are honest and if we want to be real about this, it's these frontline services that need to be protected and sustained going forward. And Minister, I'd ask you to give a commitment to look into the figures that I've given here today and see that this service is prevented or supported into the future. And we also need to look, and I'll finish at this point, at a cross-departmental approach. Because I had recently been dealing with a situation where the woman had to leave the family home because of domestic violence. But because of the housing legislation, she was unable to apply for local authority housing. And because she was unable to apply for local authority housing, she was unable to receive rent allowance. And that woman, the only place she could go to get away from a domestic partner was into a refuge and a hostel.
Okay,
now, we need to look at this in a more holistic approach, and I think we need to give it much greater time than we are here this evening. That being said, I do welcome the opportunity to contribute, albeit in a small way, this evening.